सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। ओम सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धिर्दृढ्यत्तु निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं न मत्तोऽन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Yes, summary.
In the Grantha, we were seeing the Samadhi Shatka Sampatti, and in that, we were seeing Uparatihi. And regarding Vishayanam Parityagaha, the Tippanikara has written a Tippani in which he is now giving various quotations which is showing why Vishaya should be given up. And the first is Lindu Mabhigam, Lindu Mabhigam. May I not attain Garbhavasa? May I not attain Garbhavasa? And second is
from Garbhavasa, Garbhavasa also. Generally Garbhavasa. Avasa is not there, Garbhavasa. But Avasa is not wrong. But general word is used as Garbhavasa.
And then the Kathopanishad Shruti is given Sarvendriyanam Jarayanti Tejaha. Which is all these bhogas weaken the capacity of all the organs. And then in the next Chandogya Shruti, Brahmacharyam is glorified. And it is said that whatever is called as Yajna is Brahmacharyam alone, which means Yajna is included in Brahmacharyam. And how is Yajna equated to Brahmacharyam? So Phala Drushtya. Whatever result Yajna gives, that is, Yajna gives the result in the form of attaining one's own Brahma Swarupa by way of Chitta Shuddhi. That same result Brahmacharya also gives on its own. And therefore,
on its own means what?
Not combined with this Kevala Brahmacharya, not combined with other sadhus.
Not combined with Yajna.
And then we were seeing in the Grantha, Titiksha, the next Sampatti, Titiksha. Titiksha nama, Shitoshna, Shutpipasadi, Dvandva, Sahanam. Titiksha means objective acceptance of the pairs such as cold, heat, hunger, thirst, etc. And etc. would be mana, apamana. And for Titiksha, the Tipanikara writes a Tippani. And it is said that during the occasion of Shravanam, Mananam, Nididhyasanam on Vedanta, Titiksha should be done. And what kind of Titiksha? Titiksha which is in the form of objective acceptance, Sahana Rupa. Of what? Of the obstacles to that Shravanadi. And what are the obstacles? Those obstacles are in the form of obstructing factors such as the pairs of heat, cold, hunger, thirst, etc. So during Shravanam, Titiksha in the form of objective acceptance of this pairs should be done. And then in the next part he says Vyatireka Mukhena that if such Titiksha is not done, then the mind which is engaged in the removal of those problems such as hunger, thirst, etc. For that mind, engagement in Shravanadi will not be possible. And therefore, Titiksha should definitely be done. And what does this therefore mean? Since it has been shown by Anvaya Vatireka that when Titiksha is there, then Shravanadi is possible. When Titiksha is not there, then Shravanadi is not possible. therefore it should be acquired by a mumukshu. And then in the main grantha, in the main grantha,
Mula grantha,
the granthakara answers a possible doubt. Someone can say that there are 9 sadhanas. How can you say that sadhana chatushtaya sampatti? How can you say there are 4 sadhanas only? That is answered by saying shamadinam shannamapi sadhanana eka sadhanatvena eva abhipretatva vivekadini chatvari eva sadhanani na nava iti niyam. Since all the 6 sadhana starting with shama etc. are intended to be conveyed as one sadhana alone, therefore this sadhana starting with viveka are 4 in number only, and they are not 9. In this manner it should be understood. So the doubt was based on counting this samadhi chatka sampatti as 6 sadhanas, but that is not the case. They are to be counted as 1 only, and thus there are 4 sadhanas only.
Why they are 1?
Because they are dependent on each other, and therefore they are to be seen as one package only and not separate. And regarding this eka sadhanatvena, the tippani is there, in which the tippanikara quotes various mantras from Kathopanishad to show that the mantras are showing the necessity of various sadhanas and their connection to moksha.
And also later on it will be used for showing the interconnection. Okay.
And in the first 2 mantras it is said that may one know the jivatma to be the rathaswami, and may one know the body to be the chariot. Why? Just as the chariot is dragged by horses, similarly the body is dragged by sense organs. So based on this similarity of being dragged, buddhim, and may one know the intellect to be the chariot. Oh sorry, driver. And may one, and why this to be done? Because just like the chariot is mainly driven by the sarthi, the driver, similarly this body is to be mainly driven by this, or mainly controlled by buddhi. And may one know the mind to be the reins. May you know the sense organs to be the horses.
May you know is not the reins.
The sense organs are called horses.
Okay, they declare the sense organs. Okay, that's fine. Okay.
They declare the sense organs as horses, and the sense objects as the paths for those horses. And the learned people declare the jivatma endowed with the body, organs and mind to be bhokta. And now in the next mantra, what happens when the driver is indisciplined, that is shown. So if or the driver who is not endowed with viveka, nitya nitya viveka, and who is endowed with the indisciplined mind, for him the sense organs become uncontrollable. Just like for the driver who is uninformed, the horses become wild, uncontrollable. And then in the next shloka it is said, what happens if the driver has viveka? If the driver who has viveka and who is endowed with the disciplined mind, for him the sense organs become controllable. Just like for the well-informed driver, the horses are tame, controllable.
So we are seeing sadhana chatushtaya sampatti. In that, the last one was titiksha. Titiksha is translated as endurance. You can say patience also. Patience. Or objective acceptance. And in that footnote on the titiksha, Vedanta Shravanadi Prasangesati Tatpratibandaka Shitoshnam Chutpipasadi Dvandvantaraya Sahana Rupa Titiksha Karya. Titiksha Karya means the patient should be developed, should be entertained. What type of patience or acceptance? Titiksha in the form of Sahana, putting up with objectivity, or acceptance. Titiksha in the form of acceptance of Pratibandhaka. Vedanta Shravanadi Prasangesati, when there is a situation of listening to Vedanta, during that, Tat Pratibandhaka, Shravanadi Pratibandhaka, Shita Ushna Chut Pipasadi Dvandva, pairs of opposite, which are Antaraya. Antara means which are coming in the way. Antar or antaram ayate iti antarayaha. So that which comes in the way. So obstacles to Vedanta Shravanadi which are coming in the way are to be accepted. Sahana. So objective acceptance of the obstacles to Shravana, Shravana etc., which are coming in my way. And those obstacles are in the form of Shita, Ushna, Kshut, Pipasa, etc. If that Titiksha is not there, what will happen? Anyata, Kshut, Pipasa, Adi, Pratikare, Vyapruta, Chittasya. Here it is written only Kshut, Pipasa. So, mind will be Vyapruta, engaged. In what? Removing the hunger, thirst. Bole Swami, yahan dekh rahe toh. पॉकेट में से एक निकाल के खा ले पानी तो पी लेते बट दिस दैट आल्सो विल हैपन द माइंड विल बी देयर एंड अदरवाइज व्हाट हियर शुड बी पास शीत उष्ण मींस व्हाट बोले वो फैन चालू करना है या तो फैन बंद करना है सो फैन हैज टू बी स्टॉप एंड सम पीपल व्हेन दे फील हॉट नो द वेरी बुक दे स्टार्ट यूजिंग Fan. Book is used for that. I tell them that book is not meant for that. They use it as a fan. Usse bole wahi uska sarthakta hai. That is the fulfillment of that book. So they cannot read now because they are using as a fan. One book cannot have two karya. Vakya bhe dusha bole. So there will be a problem. And therefore, mind will not be able to have engagement in Shravanadi. And therefore, avashyam titiksha sampadaniya. Titiksha should be acquired. And see, titiksha, we are going to see, titiksha comes when we have value for what we are doing. See, when people want visa and all this, and they say, nowadays it is changed, but earlier in Chennai, they say, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, people used to stand near that office to get their turn. They will do everything. Even if it is rain, they will go to the office because they want document. Chata hai na, we go there. It is required. So we go do. When we have value for something, this, that what they call sunshine or rain, we will go there. So titiksha will happen more and more when we understand the value of. And another thing is that we have underestimated our capacity. You know, we can remain without food for one day. If we don't eat, nothing is going to happen. Unless people have got some sugar problem or something. But otherwise, normal people can remain. Even without water, you can remain. People do jala, nirjala, upavasa. It's not that person dies for that. So one can. But we underestimate our capacity. Our approach is that I get a little bit hungry, I feel, immediately eat. So people eat how many times? they don't count because they don't stop, you know. If you ask them how many times stop, I don't stop, so I cannot count. Anyway, at that approach should go. Then slowly titiksha can be developed. And now in the Moolam it was there. Shamadinam Shannam api sadhanam eka sadhanatvena vabhipretatva. All six sadhanas are considered, abhipreta means intended to be conveyed as one sadhana only. How is it so? That is being explained by the Tippanikara very elaborately. How Shamadhi six sadhanas are considered to be one? The essence is they are interdependent. And how they are interdependent can be seen from the description given in Kathopanishad mantra. Therefore, Kathopanishad mantras are quoted. Okay. Atmanam Ratinam Vidhi, in this first, the third and fourth mantra of the Upanishad, the metaphor was clarified. Different factors were compared to different factors of the chariot. Then the fifth and sixth mantras describe two types of drivers. Well-informed, skilled driver and unskilled driver, uninformed driver. So, Sarathi Dvaividhyam was presented in the fifth and sixth mantra. Now, seventh and eighth mantra, Rathi Dvaividhyam. So, based on the driver a person has, what type of lot this Rathaswami have? So, Rathaswami will have two types of lots. Two types of Rathi are there. Therefore, two types of lots means the consequences will be there. So, depending upon the quality of Sarathi, the Rathi will have two types of situation. That is being said in the next two shlokas. So, earlier, fifth and sixth, Sarathi Dvaividhyam. Now, Rathi Dvaividhyam. Alright, so what is that? He said, Yastu Abhijnanavan Bhavati Amanaskas Sada Shuchihi Nasa Tatpadam Aptnoti Samsaram Chati Gacchati. Yaha, referring to Rathaswami, Jiva. The Jiva, one who is Abhijnanavan, Yahatu. One who is indeed Abhijnanavan. Means not having a good driver. Like some people don't get good driver, no? So, because not willing to pay salary, that's why one reason is that Yastu Avidhanavan Bhavati. So, what? Rathaswami Jiva, who is not having a good driver. Not having good driver means he is not having a driver with Viveka. Abhi naya naya hai. So, aisa driver hai. Amanaska. And he does not have disciplined mind. Like steering wheel is not working properly. Driver is uninformed and unskilled. Steering wheel is not working. Then what will happen? Sada ashuchihi. Always impure. And what is impurity? Yatheshtacharana pravritti. Yatheshtacharana prayukta papena dushitaha. Ashuchi means impure. Impure means what? Having licentious, instinctive behavior. So, Ashuchi means impure by instinctive behavior. Raga dvesha based behavior. Animal like life. 12 o'clock khate hai, 1 o'clock ye eat, you know. That's what the midnight snacks they call it. So, they have party, midnight snacks. This is not our culture. But all this. Whenever we feel like we get up, whenever we feel like we sleep. Generally it happens. When father is getting up, you know, then son is going to sleep. That is the timing they have. So if they can manage with one bed also. That's what I heard, this one case of father and son. Therefore I am that in my mind. So Ashuchihi. And Nasatat Padam Aptamati. He does not attain that pada, miss the highest goal. And what happens? Samsaram cha adhigachyati. And attain samsara. really speaking, does not attain samsara, remains in samsara. Or he goes into deeper samsara. Because he's already in samsara. So how can he attain samsara? So samsaram cha adhigacchati. Samsaram cha adhigacchati means he remains in samsara or he goes to deeper samsara. So this is one type of Rathaswami. Jiva who does not have good driver and good steering wheel. This good reins. Okay. Now other one, contrast. Yastu vigdanavan bhavati samanaskasada suchihi sadhu tatpadamapnoti yasmad bhuyo na jayate. Whereas the one, Rathaswami, vigdanavan bhavati, having the driver with viveka. Here vigdana means buddhi. And what type of buddhi? Sikshita buddhi. So one who is having sikshita buddhi sarathi, one who has got the driver in the form of well-informed viveki buddhi. And samanaskaha means having disciplined mind, good steering wheel. And sadashuchihi, having the purity, because there is no licentious behavior. There is behavior, the conduct based on the Shastra, Vidhi and Nisheda. Shastra, Vidhi, Nisheda nu sarena acharaha. The conduct based on the prescription and prohibition of the Shastra. And what do we mean by anusarena? That what is vihita by Shastra we do. What is Nishita? We don't do. Not opposite. Swami, maybe anusarena katta. So, whatever Shastra prohibit, that alone I do. And what it prescribes, I don't do. No, that opposite. Sada shuchihi. And in fact, that person is called refined person who leads his life in keeping with the instruction of Shastra. Tasma Shastram Pramanam Te Karya Karya Vyavasthito. It comes in Bhagavad Gita. Last shloka. So, Shastra is the Pramanam for whom in terms of conduct. That person is Shuchihi. In fact, that person is called Vijaha. One who lives his life as per the Dharma Shastra, that person is called Vijaha. Otherwise, what? Shudraha. Whether even though he is born in a Brahmana family, but he does not follow this dharma, the prescription of dharma, then Shudraha. Therefore, in Shastra it is said, Janmana Jayate Shudraha Karmana Dvija Uchyate. So, everybody is born Shudra only. Only by karma he becomes Vijaha, twice born. So really, the refinement is the characteristic of Vijaha. That Shuchihi is Vijaha. Sanskritaha. Satu tat padam aptunti. He attains that highest goal of life, yasmat, from which bhuyaha na jayate. He is not born again. So yasmat bhuyo na jayate means what? Yasmat aptat padat prachyutaha san bhuyo na jayate. Means he does not fall down from that pada and born again. In case of Brahma Loka, what happens? Other lokas, a person goes there, but he falls down and can be born again. But here, having attained Paramatma, he does not fall off from Paramatma and born again. Therefore, Yasmad Bhuyo Na Jayate. Means he attains that moksha, having attained which there is no rebirth. Then, tatpadam aptnoti, which was told in the earlier shloka mantra, that is explained in the next mantra. Vignana sarathi yahatu manah pragrahavan naraha saha advanaha param aptnoti tad vishnoho paramam padam. The second line is very popular. So dvanah param aptnoti tad vishnu paramam padam. Yaha, the Rathaswami, Who is Vigdana Sarathi? Who is having Vigdana Vana Sarathi? Viveka Vana Sarathi. One, the Iratha Swami, who was a driver in the form of Buddhi, endowed with Viveka. And Mana Pragrahavan, one who has got this mind, which is in the form of range, the disciplined mind, that Naraha, that person, Rathaswami, Saha, that Rathaswami, Advanaha Param Apnoti, he attains the other side of the path of samsara, which is what? Mokshaha, Paramatma, and Tad Vishnoho Paramam Padam, and that Advanaha Param, what is that? That is Paramam Padam, the highest abode of Vishnu. So the person who has got Viveki driver, disciplined mind, that person attains the end of samsara, Paramatma, which is Vishnoho Paramam Padam, which is the highest abode of Vishnu. When you hear this, Vishishtadvaiti, Dvaiti will be said, see, they also are talking about going to Vaikuntha. So, Vishnoho Paramam Padam means, Padam has got final meaning, Satatvam, Swarupam. This Paramatma means Satchidananda, which is the highest abode of Vishnu. Means highest abode of the Vyapanashila Ishvara. So, he attains the true nature of the all-pervasive Lord, which is Satchidananda. So, that's what we say. One attains, moksha means one attains Satchidananda. Attains Satchidananda means what? One drops the notion of becoming different from Satchidananda. The notional difference goes away. That is the Tad Vishnoho Paramam Padam. Alright, these mantras are quoted. Now, he is explaining the essence of this mantra. The next paragraph. Sharira Rupa Ratasya Indriyani Hayaha Manaha Pragraha. Indriyani Hayaha Manaha Pragraha Buddhihi Sarathi Atma Yajamanaha Rathi. This is the content of the first two mantras. Sharira Rupa Ratasya, for the chariot in the form of the body, Indriyas are Hayaha. Indriyas, the organs are the horses. The mind is the reins, Buddhi is Sarathi, driver, and Atma, Jivatma, who is called Yajamana. Yajamana literally means the ritualist. Yajati iti Yajamana. Sorry, Yajate iti Yajamana. So, one who is doing the ritual is called Yajamana. Means Karta Bhokta Jivaha. Rathi is the Rathaswami. Rathaha asti yasya sarathi. They are the owner of the chariot. And this is a beautiful way of seeing that in our culture, the jivatma, especially manushya shariraparna jivatma, is called yajamana. Means what? He will be worshipping. Because the whole life is supposed to be worship. Therefore, he is presented as yajamana. And in South India, this any grihastha is called yajamana. Aapka yajman kaun hai? Isse bolte hai. Yajmana. Who is yajmana? South India they use no yajmana. Karnataka also they use yajmana. And I think what sometimes they wipe they call yajmani. They say. Yajmani they say. So yajmana, yajmani. I don't know whether is this thrilling really yajmani it will happen. Yajmana will be happen. Yajmana. But this is feminine so ear, gip or top. So bhi chalega. So yajmani rati. So, this is the essence of the first two mantras. Then, Yasya Yajamanasya Buddhi Rupa Sarathihi Vigdanavan Kushalaha. The Yajamana, the Jiva, for whom Buddhi Rupa Sarathi, the driver in the form of intellect, is Vigdanavan. So, he is now explaining the third, fourth mantra. Vigdanavan means endowed with Viveka. Means what? Kushalaha. Kushala means expert, well-informed. Tasya, for that, Indriyashvaha, Sanmarge, Gatva, Yajamanam, Moksham, Gameyuhu. So, buddhi rupa sarthi, for whichever yajamana, is kushala. For whichever yajamana, buddhi rupa sarthi is expert. Tasya, for that yajamana, indriyashvaha, the horses in the form of organs, sanmarge gatva, having gone on the right path. What is the right path? Sanmarga means what? Both two meanings we can give. San cha aso margaha sanmargaha. San means good. Marga means path. Karmadharya. San cha aso margaha sanmargaha. Good path. Means what? Indriya for good path for Indriya will be what? Bhadram karne vishruyama devaha. Bhadram pashye makshaviri jatraha. So, Indriyas are going on the right path or going on good path means Indriyas are seeing which is Bhadram. Indriyas are hearing which is Bhadram. Means what? They are seeing that which is good for Jiva, leading him to moksha. In fact, Mangalam, and in this Ekadasha Upanishad, Mangalam means Paramatma Swarupam. So that is Mangalam. And Paramatma Swarupam, how will it be seen? Through the study of Shastra. So may I use my sense organs in Bhadram means use in the study of Shastra, etc. So Sanmarge Gatva. That is one meaning of Sanmarga. Sancha Aso Margaha. Other is Sataha Margaha Sanmargaha. The path leading to Sat Swarupa Paramatma is called Sanmarga. So, sanmarge gatva. So, organs of that person whose driver is very good will go to the right path, will travel on the right path. And then what? Yajamanam moksham gamayeyuhu. Gamayeyuhu is there, nijanta. Will make the yajamana reach. Gamayeyuhu would make reach. Yajamana, the jiva, where? Moksham. So, the organs which have been disciplined by the driver, buddhi driver, those organs having travel on the right path, good path, would make the yajamana reach to the destination moksha. Means, car is good, driver is good, steering wheel is okay, then we will reach the destination. So, car will take you there. Even if you are sleeping, it will take you there. So, otherwise every time you have to be very sure whether the landmarks are okay or not. So, we have to be very careful. And in spite of being careful, you end up somewhere else. But if organs are good, buddhi is kushala, then moksham gamayehu. This is the content of the fifth mantra. Sixth mantra. And the opposite. Viparita buddhi sarath. He has changed the order. Viparita buddhi sarathyupetaha tu yajamanah adante adanta indriyashvehi dishiddha margena narakam praptuvat. In fact, he is combining 4 to 8 all put together. So, if viparita buddhi sarathyupetaha tu yajamanah, jiva who is endowed with tumis, on the other hand, the yajamana who is endowed with buddhi, the driver in the form of buddhi which is viparita. Viparita means avignanavan, akushala, which is not having viveka, which is not skilled. Such yajamana, then adantesh, adantendriyashvehi, through the horses in the form of organs which are indisciplined, nishiddha margena, through the path of prohibited actions, narakam praptnuyat. The yajamana would reach naraka. In the earlier one, the karta was indriyani. Here karta is yajamana. Yajamana will end up in naraka. Okay. Tasma, therefore. Therefore means what? Since if good driver is there, disciplined mind is there, the disciplined organs are there, person will reach moksha. And if unskilled driver is there, indisciplined mind is there, indisciplined organs are there, then person will reach naraka. Therefore, that is the meaning. Tasmat, उक्तान्वय व्यतिरेकाभ्याम दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ तस्मात् मुमुक्षुः द सीकर ऑफ फ्रीडम बुद्धिसारथिम स्वेच्छाचारात् प्रतिनिवर्तयन् विड्रॉइंग इज अ शत्रु प्रत्यय प्रतिनिवर्तयन् विड्रॉइंग फ्रॉम स्वेच्छाचार स्वेच्छाचार मीन्स लाइसेंसियस कॉन्डक्ट इंस्टिंक्टिव कॉन्डक्ट बिहेवियर सो हैविंग मुमुक्षुः बुद्धिसारथिम स्वेच्छाचारात् प्रतिनिवर्तयन् हैविंग विड्रॉन द बुद्धिसारथि फ्रॉम दिस लाइसेंसियस बिहेवियर एंड इंद्रियाश्वान सन्मार्गे प्रवर्तये ही शुड मोटिवेट द हॉर्सेस ऑफ द ऑर्गन्स इनटू सन्मार्ग राइट पाथ जस्ट नाउ वी सॉ द मीनिंग ऑफ राइट पाथ राइट पाथ मीन्स द पाथ प्रिस्क्राइब बाय शास्त्र So once a person has got Shraddha in Shastra and Guru, then his job is almost done. Because Swamiji used to say, Shraddhavan labhate gnanam. It's a very bold statement. Right? If a person has Shraddha, he gets gnanam. Then what about Shravana Madana, Nididhyasanam, Viveka Vairagya, etc.? Don't worry. Generally, this person who has Shraddha may have all of them. And even if they are not there, His Shraddha will make him do whatever will get him other things. Vairagya, Shabadamadhi or generally we give the example. If you hand over your event to a good event manager, then your job is done. He will take care. He said, no, Hamare paas, we don't have vessels. Okay, don't worry. We'll have. We don't have people. So no problem. We'll get somebody will make your mama, somebody will be your aunt. That also they bring. I was told that they bring people also. Because nowadays, you know, most of the people have their own relatives abroad. But a sasthe mein karna hai. So, what is that? That's it. Don't worry. We'll bring people also. So, Shraddha is like that. No? Shraddha in Shastra, Shraddha in Guru. Then it is done. Therefore, Sanmarge. Sanmarge means Shastra Pratipadita Marge Pravartaye. One should motivate the organs to walk, to travel on the right path. Atra. Now we, after giving general meaning of these mantras which were given, Atra here, in this context, Buddhi Sarathehe Svavashata Padanam Shamaha. Now in the context of the description given, he is defining Shamaha. Shamaha is what? Svavashata padanam, bringing under control. What? Buddhisarathi, the driver in the form of intellect. So bringing the driver-like intellect under one's mastery is Shamaha. So this is Kathopanishad mantra based definition. Otherwise, generally we don't say buddhisarthi, manasaha, but here buddhisarthi. And indriyashva vashikaranam damaha. Mastering the horses of the organs, horses in the form of organs is damaha. Anyatra api uktam. Elsewhere also it is said, what? Manaiva manushyanam karanam banta mokshayoho. बंधाय विषयासक्तम मुक्ते निर्विषयम स्मृतम दिस श्लोक इज वेरी वेरी पॉपुलर इट इज कमिंग इन ब्रह्म बिंदु उपनिषद बट हियर ही सेज द पब्रयो सो मे बी परिव्राजक परिव्राजक ब्रह्म योग समथिंग मस्ट बी द राइट सी व्हाट इज पब्रयो यो मींस यो योग परहैप्स बट वेदर इट इज देयर और नॉट बट वन ब्रह्म बिंदु उपनिषद इट इज देयर ऑलराइट So this shloka, what does it say? Mind alone is karanam, the cause. For what? Bandha and moksha. For bondage and freedom of manushyanam, of human beings. The mind of human beings is the cause for the bondage and freedom of human beings. So your mind is the cause. So don't blame others. Swamiji, I am bound because of maya, I am... Your mind is the cause. I am Swamiji bound because of my relatives. Don't say, you are bound because of your own mind. So bandha bandha karanam bandha moksha karanam kim manaha eva. But how one and the same thing can become bandha karanam and moksha karanam? They are bandha and moksha are opposite. It's like a diarrhea and constipation. एक ही दवाई से कैसे चलेगा? एक ही दवाई से कैसे काम जाएगा? So bandha and moksha are opposite. So why one and the same mind can be the cause? That's the answer. यही अवस्था भेदना. अवस्था भेदना एक एव मनः बद्धस्य कारणं मोक्षस्य अपि कारणं. One and the same mind becomes the cause for bondage, cause for freedom, depending upon the avastha, the state of the mind. One state of mind is creating bondage, and one type of mind, another type of mind is getting freedom. It's possible. Like, you know, sometimes in button, if you press one time, it starts. You press twice, it stops. Happens or not? So that is possible. Now you have got examples. Ekeva button, sangeetasya, sangeeta nivruttehe ubhayoho api karanam bhavati. So it is possible. Okay. Now what is that? Which mind is bandha karanam? Which mind is moksha karanam? He says, bandhaya vishaya sattam. Bandhaya means bandha karanam ityartha. We have to understand this manner. विषया सक्तम मनः बंधाय कारणं भवति और बंध कारणं भवति. सो द माइंड विच इज अटैच्ड टू द ऑब्जेक्ट्स अहम मम भावेन आसक्तम इज बंधाय कारणं इज द कॉज फॉर द बॉन्डेज. इन अवर लाइफ वी कैन सी दिस वेरी वेल. व्हाई डू वी दिस बंध मींस samsara. Samsara means what? Dukkha. So why dukkha is there? Because we have insistence for something. Your agraha and vigraha. I generally tell these two things. See, these two grahas you have to take care. Rahu, Ketu, Ma, Mangala, Buddha, etc. They require to take care. But these two you take care. Agraha, vigraha. Agraha means insistence. This is the only way. This is how it should be. My way or highway. That's it. My way or highway. This is a sure means, is a guaranteed means for dukkha. One who is all the time having insistence, you know, that person is guaranteed he will become dukkhi. For some time, yes, some people will oblige. When you are a small child, many of your demands were fulfilled, especially when you are a single child. So that those children sometimes spoiled because they think that whatever I want should happen, because that's what happened. My parents, whatever asked, it happened. So generally parents, you know, they don't take care of this aspect. That sometimes they have to say no also if the demand is improper. They don't do it. So child becomes, you know, we think that whole world is at my disposal only. They say that the people who were the English people who were working in this colonized India before independence, they, when they go back to England, they were not given any job. That was one observation. Why? Because when they were in India, they used to order. If they are traveling by train, he said, let this stop. No stop. You know, I want. How long? As long as I want. Even not only that officer, they will, the boss over, their children also. Children also will say, no, I don't want this train to start. Then all the drivers and the guards and will come to that compartment and say, give chocolate and all this. The child has to say, let it go. That type of, you know, the children will spoil. Therefore, when they go back, it happened that one couple, they had some son, and once he did like that. He said, let train be stopped in India. And it was stopped. And after the child was pleased, he gave permission, then only train was started. Otherwise, I will give whips. He will say, I will whip the person. If he doesn't listen to me, we'll whip, because that is what British parents used to do. The child also starts saying this. And when this fellow, the mother and son, they went. Father was here. They went there, and the train, some train, this child wanted to stop. And he said, stop. Nobody was stopping. And the child started saying, we will whip the driver, we'll whip the driver. Then mother was very embarrassed then. Because he has yet to explain to the child, we are not in India. Anyway, so this insistence comes to the children. And when they grow also, they feel that way. And that insistence that everything should go my way only, that makes person dukkhi. Vigraha, resistance to the fact, why it happened to me? Okay. And that type of mind, asakta manaha, who is having this insistence regarding the objects, people and situation, resistance to the objects, people and situation, that what? Bandhaya. So vishyasaktam should be seen in a very larger perspective. A person who is asakta, asakta means attached to the objects, people and situation. And attached means what? He wants all the objects, all people, all situations should give him happiness all the time. Somehow it is a very wrong thinking. We think that the world has responsibility to make me happy. It's a very, very wrong conclusion. This vishyasakta mana is that. My people say that my wife should make me happy, my husband should make me happy, my parents should make me happy, my friends should make me happy. Wrong thing. Let us stop. We should not think somebody has given contract to my wife to make me happy. That's a wrong thing. So this is vishyasaktamana. This is bandhaya, bandha karanam bhavati. And muktaye nirvishayam smritam. Nirvishayam manaha. Nirvishayam here is in the sense of anasaktam manaha. Vishaya anasaktam. The mind which is not attached to the objects. Opposite. Is smritam, is considered muktaye, means muktikaranam. So vishayasaktam manaha bandhaya karanam bhavati. Nirvishayam manaha muktaye sadhanam smritam karanam smritam. Nirvishayam manaha means what? Who does not look upon the objects, people and situation to be the source of happiness. Means they do, he doesn't think that my happiness is dependent upon that. The source of happiness is myself. Raso vaisaha. So, all become ananda because of me. I, Brahma, alone am the original source of happiness. That's why we give the example of the dog. No? Dog is biting the bone and thinking that what? This rasa is coming from the bone. It is this rasa is coming from himself, his own body, his own tongue. So this nirvishayam manaha muktaye sadhanam. So from this what we understand? That mind is the main factor. And afterwards he will say, therefore mana chikitsa, next mantra is called, mana chikitsa is the solution. Since mind is the problem, therefore mind is the solution. Healthy mind is the solution. Problematic mind is problem, is the cause for samsara. Now, next one it is said, chittam karanam arthana. The mind is the cause for the objects. Thus, why? How do we say that? Anvaya vyatirika abhyam. By anvaya and vyatirika, co-presence, co-absence. Means what? Manaha sattve, artha sattvam. Manaha abhave artha bhava. When mind is there, then only objects are experienced. Mind is not there, objects are not there for you. So, anvaya vyatireka abhyam chittam arthanam karanam. What is the anvaya vyatireka logic? Yas sattve yas sattvam yadabhave yadabhavaha tattasya karanam. If A is, B is. A is not there, B is not there. Therefore, A is the cause for B. This is called anvaya vyatireka logic. So, chittam is the karanam, the cause for artha. Why? Because there is anvaya vyatireka between the mind and the objects. What? If chittam is there, arthas are available. Chittam is not there, arthas not available. That anvaya vyatireka he presents in the next part of the shloka. Tasmin sati jagatrayam. In fact, this is a hetu upapadana. Hetu, not hetu upapadana. Hetu. Why chitta karanam arthanam? Yataha tasmin manasi sati jagatrayam. When the mind is, tasmin sati means manasi sati. When the mind is, jagatrayam asti. Threefold world. Jagatrayam refers to triloka. Bhuhu, bhuvaha, suvaha. So it's called triloka. The world is presented in the form of three lokas. Jagatrayam. And tasmin kshine. When the mind is resolved. Sushupta. Tasmin sati where? Jagra swapna yoho. In Jagrat and Swapna, when mind is there, Jagatrayam is there. Tasmin kshine. In Sushupti, when mind is resolved, Jagat shtinam. The world is resolved. Aapu muvetu dubagai dunya. That's how in this say. If you are not there, world is gone. For you. Tasmin kshine jagat shtinam. Therefore what? Tasmat tat. Tat refers to mana. Chittam. Chikitsyam. Chikitsyam is treated. Therefore, the mind should be treated. Prayatnataha. Diligently. Means everybody is a psychic patient. Yehi keh rahe. We think that only some people are psychic. You know. No. He says, tat manaha eva chikitsyam. Chikitsyam means should be treated. Only thing is, this some people require the regular psychiatrist and other people who are generally considered to be normal. But they are what? They are abnormal only. But they are normally abnormal. So that those who are normally abnormal, they also require mental treatment. Abnormally abnormal, of course, require mental treatment. In fact, they require particular type of psychiatric treatment. But these normally abnormal people require the treatment. What type of treatment? Shastra. Guru Vaidya. So Guru is a Vaidya. In the Shastra Upadesha is a Bheshajam. Shastra Upadesha Bheshaja. Guru Vaidaka Chikitsa. That type of Chikitsa is required. He requires the treatment where Shrotriya Brahmanishta Guru is the doctor and the teaching of Shastra, knowledge of Shastra is the medicine. Alright, so Tachikitsyam Prayatnataha. So, deliberately, that is to be treated. In fact, that person is called a spiritual person. One who has stopped blaming the world for one's own problem. I am unhappy because he is not alright, say he is not alright, it is not alright. That is a samsara. As long as you are blaming the world for your misery, suffering, sorrow, you are samsara. When you start taking responsibility for your misery, your sorrow, and start working on that, you are a That is the definition of spiritual pursuit. Spiritual pursuit is not that growing beard, going to the ashram, staying in the ashram all the time, sitting in meditation. Generally people think that alone is spirituality. No. Spirituality is stop blaming the world taking the responsibility and being committed to the inner growth leading to self-discovery. That is for spirituality. And so that's why tat manaha chikitsam prayatnataha. Can I tell you, when you are busy with this, let me correct the mind. Let me correct my attitude. Let me correct my wrong understanding. Let me remove the ignorance about certain facts of my life. Let me remove the ignorance of myself. If you are busy with that, then you will not bother about other things. You are so busy with that. Other things don't bother you. You are so busy with that. Shastra, they gave the example. A blacksmith was asked, do you know the procession of the king has passed by? He said, no. The procession of the king will not be ordinary, no? So many horses will be there, the elephants will be there, the chariots will be there. He said, I don't know. Anyatra manaha abhuvam. I was so busy because he was doing one arrow, making one arrow. And the arrow should be very sharp. And when you are making something sharp, if you sharpening is not too much, it will become blunt again. So you have to be very careful. So you have to have full focus. When it is there, you won't even know what is happening. Really, some people, those who are very focused, they will not know if you ask them that how many trees are on the way, how many trees, which are the trees. I don't know. I remember one ashram in Bangalore, I used to go for years together. 10-15 years I was going. I exactly did not know what tree. That other person came for one day and he told Swami, oh, here it is this tree, here it is this tree. Oh, achha, I said, I am being fast. You are focused. You know, some people are looking at me or not looking at me, it doesn't matter. Well, you are so busy with yourself. Most of our issues will be dropped, irrelevant, when this you are focused to. Making correction inside your mind. And you understood that lies the solution. When I did not correct my wife, I did not correct my spouse, also husband or children and all. If I correct my mind, it's okay. Like the whole area is having dust. You cannot clean all the area. You have to wear shoes, that's all. You wear shoes, your problem is solved. Most of the people are, you know, cleaning the area. So, only intelligent person wear the shoes. So, similarly, tat chikitsyadam chikitsyam prayatnata. More in the next case. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Guru.